Oh. Hello. Sorry about that. Just enjoying the view. We got stuff to do. The Black Wolf's ultimatum. Menphilia is greatly concerned by recent developments concerning the Council of the Alliance leaders. Grim tidings, Alara. It seems that word of the Ultima weapon's existence has already reached the Alliance leaders in the form of an ultimatum. They have gathered in the Fragrant Chamber and are deliberating their answer even as we speak. Beleaguered as they are, I fear they may well elect to lay down their arms in the belief that surrender will spare their people untold suffering. Yet nothing could be further from the truth. That which the Black Wolf offers will doom Eorzea, not deliver it, and the leaders must be made aware of this. Let us hurry to them, Delara, and assure that they do not act in ignorance of the consequences. Yeah, a lot of people do. Just how we are. The Council of the Alliance leaders is presently in process of the Fragrant Chamber. I must ask that you step away from the doors, madam. I'm sorry? You're here on behalf of the Scions of the Seventh Dawn? A thousand pardons, my lady. Of course you may enter. How dare you try and shoo me from the door?
We keep treading the same ground.
Ground.
Van Belsar's demands are clear.
Alas, our minds are not.
I've never been one to shy from a fight, but if this weapon of theirs can do all they claim...
It has been 5 years since the calamity, and our people have scarce begun to rebuild their lives. Can we now, in good conscience, call upon them to risk what little they have left? I would spare them the pain of further conflict. Conflict, I say, though that would imply forces set in opposition. If the combined might of three primals could not stay Garlemald's new terror, what meaningful resistance can we offer? We who struggle to quell the foes who rise up within our own borders.
Long have we fought the primals, but to what end? We strike them down at no small cost, only for them to rise again and again. Are we to play this profitless game for the rest of days? I, for one, grow tired of it. Mistake me not. I do not propose to trade one tyranny for another. I love liberty. But conciliation need not mean oppression.
By the 12, though neither of you cried surrender, your every word betokened it. Not that I deny there is truth in what you say. Nor can I rightly claim that Ul'dah is ready to fight. Refugees flood our gates, and beastmen swarm our land, while the great and the good do nothing. My flames struggle to bear the burden. I put on a grand show at the Remembrance Service, made all manner of lofty promises. I've made good on not a bloody one.
Do not blame yourself, Rauban. You said only that which the people needed to hear. All present have done the same. Our citizens had become lost to hope. If our words serve to kindle it in them anew, better we speak than remain silent. Our enemy condemns us for failing our people. Yet what does he care for their well-being? While we labored to rebuild their lives, the Black Wolf built instruments of murder with which to end them.
Her Majesty speaks true. For all our failings, the people's well-being has ever been our foremost priority. While none among us ever doubted that the Empire would one day resume its war, we scarcely had means enough to solve the problems of the present.
Aye, which is why we look to others to safeguard our future. The Scions of the Seventh Dawn, alas, they are gone, and the Black Wolf is at our door.
Admiral! I fear you are mistaken!
Alphinord, Minfilia, and Seven Hells! Master Garland?
And you, dear friend?
By Ralga, you're alive! All of you.
As we approached, I would swear I heard talk of surrender. But I know that cannot be. It is not the Eorzean way.
Hear me, my friends. Accepting the Garlean's offer to vanquish the Primals would be folly. Folly, I say. For might is not the answer to the Primal threat. Indeed, the more the Empire exerts its strength, the worse matters will become. Primals enter this world when mortals call upon them, and mortals are wont to appeal to a higher power when they are desperate. Nothing is more certain to breed desperation in the Beast Tribes than the Garlean's proposed solution.
The true answer lies in a lasting peace, but the Garleans only know war and conquest. Should Eorzea fall into their hands, there will be such suffering as none can imagine.
We are not blind to the many challenges that each of your nations face. Yet you must not give in.
Aye. Remember 5 years ago when you wagered all for the sake of the realm? Remember what you fought for, what you were willing to die for. Let the memories rekindle the fire in your heart, for Eorzea has need of it again.
Come what may, we Scions will never give up the fight. And so I bid you stand with us, and together we shall safeguard the future of the realm.
A great man once said that a shrewd merchant grasps not for the quick profit, but invests in the future. Wise words, eh, Rauban?
Cid, I...
Your words stir and shame me in equal measure. How could I contemplate surrender? I know full well that all we have, we owe to the sacrifices of those who went before us. Yet the seeming hopelessness of our plight robbed me of my insight. We Gridanians have no love for war. Yet we have still less for those who would threaten our homeland. Ever have we fought to protect those things we hold dear, and this shall never change. Gridania will go to war. We will fight the Empire. For the sake of the realm, and all who abide here.
Yeah, yeah. Words worthy of a fountain.
founder of the Alliance. Ralbon, are we to be outdone?
I lost one homeland. The thought of losing another had blunted my resolve. But no man knows better than I that if you want aught, you'd best be ready to die for it. With great danger comes the chance for great glory and great profit. We Ul'dahs who have turned sand into gold know this well. How many times have we fallen into the pit of despair, only to have you pluck us out? I've fair lost count.
Reckless, the lot of you, like bloody pirates. Well, I won't waste my breath trying to talk you round. On account of being a pirate myself. And the pirate who shrinks from a challenge is no pirate at all. Those who would pick a quarrel with us must choose. Back down, or go down with all hands. Let the Garleans come. The united strength of Limsa Lominsa will be waiting for them.
If our realm is to be free of this pall of darkness, let it be by our own hands.
For Eorzea!
We must needs consider how the weapon may be brought to bear against us.
The Maelstrom will secure strategic points along the coastline.
In the meantime, the flames will deploy at...
Be at ease, my friends. You have banished our doubts. Pray leave the military matters to us and retire to the Waking Sands. We will send word anon.
I do have one question. What are they gonna do about that smoke that's in that room? Do they have a ventilator?
I cannot well express my relief to think that the Alliance came so close to surrender.
But the fire in their hearts has been rekindled, and they will fight to the last.
This warmth inside. Did you feel it too, Grandfather? I would know something. Was that your power at work earlier?
Nothing of the sort. The leaders of Eorzea had lost their way. I merely helped them to find it again. Oh, hello. Yes, our party returned just a moment ago. How close are you? It's all right, Cid.
We must needs plan our next move. Pray continue liaising with your respective nations. Cid, would you be our man in Ul'dah?
I'll be whatever and wherever you need me to be.
We haven't a moment to waste. All right, let's do this!
Thancred's fate weighs heavy on my mind. I cannot bear to think of him enthralled to an Ascian. Mayhap you know this already, but the Ascians are immortal beings without physical form. Since time immemorial, they have fanned the flames of chaos from the shadows. That they might work unseen, the Ascians entrap and possess mortal men by means of malign artifacts known as Crystals of Darkness. One such crystal may yet be the key to saving Thancred.
This is a crystal of darkness.
A mere replica, created using data obtained from anomalous crystals found across Eorzea.
It comes to us courtesy of the students of Baldessian, our distant allies. Even for an Archon, Thancred's talents are exceptional. We all had complete confidence in him. It was for this reason that none among us foresaw the danger in sending him to investigate the Asians alone.
Thancred had been striving to fill the void left by Louissoir. Yet, it was plain that he was overtaxing himself.
Yeah, he would volunteer for everything and work till he was dizzy.
And the toll taken by his exertions made him vulnerable to Asian influence.
The crystal that binds Thancred must be somewhere on his person. If we could but destroy it, his Asian possessor would be compelled to relinquish control over him. You have proven the stoutest of allies, standing with us through thick and thin. Yet the most perilous struggle is still to come. For the sake of the realm and Thancred, I ask that you lend us your strength once more. Thank you, from the bottom of my heart. As I am sure you are aware, the realm was saved from certain doom 5 years ago by heroes known as the Warriors of Light. What you may not be aware of is that your many feats in service to the Scions have prompted folk to make certain comparisons. I must confess, you do remind me of them. Yet remember this, however glorious the past, it is the hero's lot to be judged on the deeds of the present. A new darkness threatens the realm, and the people cry out for a savior. I believe that you are she, a warrior of light, here in the present, guided by the crystal's will. Come, my friends, let us fight to safeguard the future of our beloved Eorzea.
Operation Archon. Menphilia will brief you on the Eorzean Alliance's planned counteroffensive against the Empire. All present? Then let us begin. We have received the details of the impending operation. In what promises to be the largest single counteroffensive in the realm's troubled history, the Alliance will strike every Imperial stronghold standing upon Eorzean soil. As might be expected, the operation will be complex, but you need not commit its intricacies to memory. It is enough that each man understands his part and plays it to the best of his ability. The finer instructions you will receive at each station point. To begin, let us review the distribution of our forces. From west to east, the maelstrom of Limsa Lemensa, the immortal flames of Ul'dah, and the Order of the Twin Eder of Gridania. Next, let us examine the locations of the Imperial strongholds. Near Limsa Lemensa, we have Castrum Ossidens, situated in eastern Valbrid, and Castrum Meridium, which lies to the south and east in the midst of the Rotano Sea. Near Ul'dah, we have Castrum Meridian. I got those two mixed up. To the north, and the coastal outpost at Cape Westwind, which connects Castrum Marinum to the mainland by means of a Magitek transporter. Near Gdynia, we have Castrum Oriens, which lies upon the eastern edge of the Twelveswood. And finally, in Mordana, stands Castrum Sentry, a thorn in the heart of Eorzea. The forthcoming operation will see Allied forces assault each of the aforementioned locations, with the ultimate objective of destroying the Empire's new weapon, housed within Castrum Meridium. As one might expect of the Black Wolf's seat of power, Castrum Meridianum boosts all but impenetrable defenses. If we are to breach it, we must needs isolate it from its sister strongholds. To do otherwise would be to risk being caught twixt hammer and anvil. The operation will comprise four distinct phases, all told. The first shall see us eliminate one of the Black Wolves' most trusted lieutenants, Redantanses Arvina. Oh, the names. Every time. According to Arvin's investigation, the Prefectus is due to visit the Imperial outpost at Cape Westwind for an inspection. When he arrives, we shall dispatch an elite adventuring unit to eliminate him. Delara, we would have you lead this assault. Matantin is a peerless field tactician. Short of his leadership, the garrison at Castrum Ossidens will be as a snake without its head. Phase 2 will see us sever Castrum Meridium's primal lines of supply. As soon as Ratanin's presence is confirmed at the coastal outpost, the Maelstrom will lay siege to Castrum Ossidens. Smack. At that very hour, the Lamensin Armada, helmed by the Admiral herself, shall move to blockade Castrum Marinum. Meanwhile, in the Twelveswood, the Order of the Twin Adder will surround Castrum Oriens. And they'll have the cells to help them. Phyrexia has been waiting for a chance to avenge these ones. Phase 3 shall see us neutralize Castrum Meridium's defenses. Forming our main thrust, the Immortal Flames will march against the stronghold with all their strength. While the enemy's eyes are thus drawn outwards, another elite adventurer unit shall infiltrate the Castrum. Its mission: to disable the Magitek field generator which protects the Praetorium, a fortress within a fortress within the wherein the ultimate weapon is believed to be housed. Delara, we would have you take command once more. Meanwhile, the Order of the Twin Adder will blockade the railway which connects Sentry and Meridium, preventing the timely arrival of reinforcements from Mordana. A wise precaution, the monstrous locomotive which runs back and forth between the two castros is capacious enough to transport a small army by all accounts. It is well that Garlians did not think to give her wings. Once Meridium's defenses have been compromised, the operation will enter its fourth and final phase. This will see the Immortal Flames enter the stronghold and suppress the remnants of the enemy garrison, allowing Delara's units to pass unopposed into the Praetorium, where they will locate and destroy the Ultima weapon. Boink. By this feat shall the operation be deemed a success. In addition to the Grand Companies, we cannot count upon the support of a variety of other parties, or we can, from the pirates of Limsa Limensa to the Monteris of Ul'dah. In all, the operation will involve no fewer than 12 major factions. Legend holds that the Archons were 12 and 1, and 1 and 12. It is for this reason that our grand endeavor has been dubbed Operation Archon. Countless free companies have also pledged their swords, and more join us by the day. At long last, all of Eorzea is rising as one. As before, we Scions shall work in concert with the grand companies, Ida, Papalimo, Yestola. Pray accompany our respective organizations on their missions. Uriange, I would have you represent us in Ul'dah. Reassure the financiers that they had made a sound investment. When that is done, pray return here and aid in the coronation of our forces. Tataru, please assist Uriange in any way you are able, and assure that everyone is kept abreast of the latest developments. Minfilia, Sid, and I shall accompany the main host in an advisory capacity. It will be our task to analyze intelligence as it comes into our possession, and make the necessary recommendations to command. As Alphino mentioned, you are to lead the elite unit of adventurers whose task it will be to see each of Operation Archon's main objectives fulfilled. Yours is the most important role of all, and like to be the most dangerous. Pray choose your party well, and stint not in your preparation. The battle for the future of the realm is about to begin. Together, let us show the Black Wolf the power of a united Eorzea. Pray report to the Immortal Flames and Camus situated to the north of here when you are ready to be briefed on your first mission. I cannot stress this enough, but please be careful. May you walk in the light of the crystal. Nice warm fire, along with a chocobo.
You are welcome, Lord Waters of the Scions. As communications officer, it falls to me to issue you your orders and provide guidance on forthcoming missions. Your first mission is to infiltrate the Imperial outpost at Cape Westwind and eliminate Perfectus Raitana Sas Urvana Avena. All participating units are now in position and awaiting your arrival. Please proceed to the staging point and report to Lieutenant Audibert. This is but the first step in our bid to purge the realm of the Garlean menace. I shall pray for your success. It's good, boy. Sir Dolores Waters, the fearless adventurer whose turn to lead the assault. We've been expecting you. Our Maelstrom friends report that Raitana Sasavina departed Castrum Ocidon Zabelgo. And sure enough, a convoy of Imperial airships landed here just now. The likelihood is high that our target was aboard one of the vessels. I've dispatched scouts to verify his presence before we strike. Command to all units, requesting status report. This is Antlion target. Has not been sighted.
Antlion 1. Target has not been sighted.
This is Antlion 2. Likewise, target has not been sighted.
Antlion 3 here. We've got nothing for you neither.
This is Antlion 4. Nothing to report as of...
Wait! Disregard previous message. Target sighted. I say again, target sighted.
Understood. Hold your position.
Attention all units. This is Lieutenant Audibert Cotter.
The first step of Operation Archon begins with us. Should we falter here, all hope of victory will be lost. 'Tis no small burden, but know that I believe in all of you. So believe in yourselves, and together we will blaze a path for our brothers and sisters of the Alliance to follow. We will create multiple diversions and disperse the enemy garrison. That should give your people a chance to breach their defenses. Go now, Dalara, and bring us Raitana's head. May Ra'gal grant you strength.
Uh-huh. Commence diversionary maneuvers. Look at me, Boing, boing. It would appear we have unexpected guests. Now, where have I seen you before? Ah, but of course, the woman who fell the mighty tyrant. This is the Icon Slayer? I see, the commotion without is naught but a diversion. Allow me to hazard a guess. By eliminating me, you hope to undermine the garrison at Ocidens. A bold strategy to be sure, but have you the strength to see it to fruition? Leave us. None of you are a match for her. Send word to Cash from Ocidens. Tell them the Lamentons are coming. At once, my lord. Fifteen years have come and gone since Lord Van Balsall first set foot in Eorzea, yet his ambition for the realm burns as strong as ever it did. Know you what fuels that adventure? The desire to deliver the people from their suffering. The lands he has conquered were all beset with problems, poverty, starvation, lawlessness, and strife. My homeland was no exception. Had my lord not reached out and claimed it for the Empire, it would eventually have destroyed itself. But under his sage leadership, my people enjoyed such peace and stability as we have never known. And he only desires the self-same for the people of this realm. Under his rule, Eorzea would be free from the shackles which bind it, the shackles of false faith. There would be no feeble leaders to misguide the masses, no icons to bleed the realm dry. True peace would reign and the people would be free to live their lives without fear of persecution or oppression. Should you doubt the truth of my words, I bid you look upon me. I am no son of Garlemald, yet Lord Van Belso saw fit to raise me to a station of great honor. He measures a man not by his birth, but by his worth. Such is his sense of justice. By the grace of his excellency, I am where I was born to be, upon the field of battle. He has given me a noble cause to fight for, and worthy adversaries to smite. I am not wont to bear my steel needlessly, but if you are deaf to reason... In the name of Lord Van Balsa, I, Ritana Asvarina, do swear to strike you down! Rawr. Got wrecked. Forgive me, I have failed you. No, Lord Van Balsar. Wop. That light, the magic tech transporter. Delara, are you there? What news of Ritanian? Fallen?
With this deed, you have sown the seeds of our ultimate victory. The fading of that light presages an end to the Empire's tyranny. Atanasas Arvana is no more. Let the next phase of Operation Archon commence. Yeah, hurrah! Tis I. It seems you have done it again, Delara. I'd raise a tanker to you, but I'm afraid we've no time to savor the victory. There's still the small matter of infiltrating Kestra Meridium and destroying the Ultima weapon. I know, no rest for you preternaturally gifted. Now, stop feeling sorry for yourself and make your way back to the Immortal Flames encampment. The communications officer will issue you your orders. I'll be waiting for you with the main host. Look, Heidelin. Your minion comes, bringing the light. Alas, the gate to the void already stands open. Soon, darkness shall consume all, and you shall bow down before the one true god. Okay. The Perfectus slain? Regrettably so, my lord. And by the hand of the Icon Slayer, the Centaurian who survived the attack is to be believed. Redunton! I have no idea how to pronounce that name. Where was his men when he faced the enemy? Fleeing even as their commander yielded up his last breath? If it should prove they question his right. I cannot speak for them, my lord. Beg pardons, my lord, but there is more. The Maelstrom has laid siege to Kestrum Ocidens. Likewise, the Crimson Fleet moves to blockade Kestrum Marinium. Marinum. There's so many of those variations. So this is their answer. Very well, we shall crush them as we crush the Icons. Go forth and show them the futility of their resistance. Yes, my lord. Cyan Waters, your deeds this day are an inspiration to us all. With the death of the Perfectus, Operation Archon has entered its second phase. Even as we speak, the Maelstrom moves to blockade Kestrum Ocidens and Kestrum Marinum. And far to the east, in the Black Shroud, the Order of the Twin Adder advances upon Kestrum Orions. Already, you have done much to advance our cause, performing such feats as are worthy of a song. But if our plan is to succeed, more is required of you. Let me know when your preparations are in order, and I shall relay to you the particulars of your next mission. A hero in need. The Allied Communications Officer has a task that can only be performed by a hero of the Alliance. Phase 2 of the operation is presently in motion. Our brothers and sisters of the Maelstrom are holding their own against Garland forces upon Valbrand and the Rotana Sea. Ere long, the third phase will begin and you must take to the field once more. The Immortal Flame shall strike at Kestra Meridinium by way of a diversionary maneuver. While the Garlians are thus locked in battle, you are to infiltrate the stronghold and bring down the magic tech field that surrounds the Praetorium. The staging point for the mission lies in the shadow of Kestra Meridinium, in northern Thanalan. I'm always going to get that wrong, so just take that. And that is where you must go. On your way there, however, I would ask that you make a brief stop at Camp Blue Fog, one of our key outposts in the area. Almost looks like Blue Frog. The garrison, I am told, is in low spirits, and it would do our troops well to see the hero of Cape Westwind appear before them. For the good of our cause, please stoke the fire in their hearts.
Ah, Sergeant Waters, yours is a most welcome present here at Camp Blue Fog.
I'm almost tempted to say Blue Frog.
Logistically speaking, we are ready to march on Castrum Marinum at a moment's notice. Alas, while our troops are here in body, their minds are anywhere but.
The garrison's mood is dark, so daunting is the prospect of joining what may prove to be the bloodiest battle in history. But with a hero such as you walking among them, we may yet rekindle the dwindling embers within their souls.
Are their souls dark souls?
The ladle in the darkness. Sergeant Crackfist needs a hero to make a stew. Yum yum.
I have a favor to ask of you as a fellow comrade of the Alliance. As I mentioned, the garrison's mood is dark. The fault, it pains me to admit, is partly mine. I am no veteran of large-scale campaigns, you see, and the men and women under me are nervous for this knowledge. Seeking to lift their spirits, I remember the tale of a Gridanian general from a century past. Vanishalon was his name, and he was a lancer of great renown. History holds that in spite of his rank, he would regularly cook meals for his troops while afield.
Hello, bots. Go away.
Most generals know to break bread with their own men on occasion to foster camaraderie, but Vanishalon took it one step further by actually making that bread. He showed that he was truly one of them, a hero and a comrade. Though I wouldn't presume to compare myself to a man of his stature, I thought it might be well to at least emulate the deed. To be sure, this is a testament to my desperation. I have begun making preparations for a ballistic stew, all the while wondering whether it would be any good. When an honest to God's hero appeared. I speak of you, of course. My gratitude would know no bounds if you could take up the ladle in my stead. Stew is just about ready. All it needs is some basilic meat, which can be readily had north of here. Please procure the meat and add it to the cauldron bubbling just outside the camp. When the stew is ready, I would ask that you also distribute it among our troops. Receiving the stew from you is a certain to give them heart. I doubt I can say the same were it to come from my hands.
More murder.
Basilisk meat. Only those who have never eaten basilisk meat claim it has the consistency of chicken. Those who have eaten basilisk meat will tell you the consistency is more akin to boot leather, as if the flavor. Yum. I like eating leather. Gotta taste as good as it smells, huh? I think I'll pretend to be sick. That way I won't have to fight. Maybe they'll even send me home to my family. Sounds as if one man would make a difference, right? Basilisk stew. A hodgepodge of basilisk meat, random roots, and whatever other edible flora and fauna can be foraged from the desert. Here's some miscellaneous stuff. You made the stew? For me? I never dreamed that I would share a meal with a hero, let alone partake of something she made. I wanted to be a hero too, you know? To my family. I took up arms because I wanted to protect them, and I will. I won't run, not today, nor any other. Gods, this is all so hopeless. The Girlians are going to crush us with their steel monstrosities. We're all going to die. I'm so sorry. I don't know what came over me. Your words and this hearty stew have given me courage. And yes, a fire positively burns in my belly. Or is it just the basilisk venom? Oof.
That doesn't sound good.
Man, it's always so dark here and cold. Maybe I shouldn't have enlisted. It's not like killing guardians will bring my friend back. This smells good. Aren't you the adventurer who triumphed to Cape West Wind? To think that a hero fights beside us! And this stew, what's my appetite for vengeance? Just you wait, you Garlean horsens, I'm coming for your heads! Mwahahaha!
Your basilisk stew has done wonders for our troops' morale. I can't thank you enough. The seeming hopelessness of the situation, not to mention this accursed gloom, had dampened their spirits, and for a time, they had forgotten their purpose. But your presence and the culinary skills helped them to remember. I'm confident they will do their part to protect the realm and their loved ones. Oh man. It's been fairly eventful. Quite a lot of cutscenes, a lot of voicing, but you know, sometimes you have to stop, and that's where I'm going. They got their food, and I'm gonna get me some food, and if you're hungry, go get you some food, so I'm gonna catch you guys later. Cha-cha! Cha-cha!